News Channel 8 also doing some more digging into the case of Tracy Bess. You'll recall we first broke the story last Friday at 10 o'clock. Police say that Bess had been promising couples that she would let them adopt her unborn baby, but she was never pregnant. Patrick Bell has new details on all this tonight. Patrick?
Yeah, Kevin, here's that new information we've uncovered, and there's lots of it, from search warrants to criminal complaints to police reports. This investigation is growing, and more potential victims are speaking out tonight.
Investigative reports obtained by News Channel 8 reveal even more couples in even more states claiming to be deceived by 25-year-old Tracy Bess. Detectives believe she not only lied about being pregnant, but intentionally targeted those desperate to adopt a child.
She even texted us a couple of pictures of the supposed baby, and the pictures fit what she was telling us. And so it made it even more believable.
J.D. and Jennifer Jordis say they traveled from Nebraska to meet Tara Snyder, a young woman they believed had just given birth and was ready to relinquish parenting rights.
Oh, yeah, we are extremely excited. Having waited for so long to add to our family, we are definitely stoked about it. But we are always a little nervous because they can always change their mind at any time. But we are hopeful.
But their dreams were shattered when they learned Tara was actually Tracy Bess. The deeply disappointed couple then returned home without the child they'd longed to love.
So we're frustrated, angry, surprised. I mean, we had so many emotions going through us that I think we were just floored.
As for motive, this search warrant filed by Ankeny police officers indicates after Bess was arrested last week on an unrelated charge, she told them she had contacted at least 10 prospective parents, but probably more than that. She admitted she was never pregnant, that she was having mental health issues, and by the time she realized what she was doing was wrong, it was too late. When we talked to Bess at the Polk County Jail...
Like I said, there's a $1,000 bond. If you want to know anything about me, then get me out of here and I'll tell you.
And to be very clear here, we did not and would not ever provide bail for a story. Now, the Polk County attorney says prosecutors are still working this case, and additional charges could be filed if and only if it's determined Tracy Bess actually stole something, Kevin. Emotional scamming, as it's sometimes called, is not a crime.
Can be cruel, though.
Yes, it can.
Thank you very much, Patrick.